Welcome back to another episode of Muddy River Catfishing. Today we're just going to do a little fishing on one of my favorite fishing spots. And I've got chicken liver chum bait and shrimp for bait today. I went down to Walmart to buy some worms, and their fridge was broken, so they didn't have any. I prepared the chum bait a little different today. I decided to add the clam juice and the garlic to it, just to see what it would do, if it would help it or make any kind of a difference. And on the other hook, I'm just going to use shrimp. I didn't like that cast. We've actually been getting a lot of rain lately, but it still hasn't been enough to help our lake or any of these places that I like to fish. The water continues to be really low. Our biggest lake is Elephant Butte Lake, one of my favorite places to fish, and its capacity is 2.2 million acre feet of water. And right now it currently stands at 65,000 acre feet of water only. That's about 3% of its maximum capacity. So yeah, it's pretty dry. If you go to my Facebook page and it's just type in Muddy River Catfishing, you'll see that posting, and they actually have satellite images that were taken. One was taken in 1994 and the other one was taken this year. And the water level is just heartbreaking. Supposed to be in the triple digits today, so I'll probably be fishing in the water here a little later on. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning right now, and I can already feel the heat. A whole lot of action, huh? Yeah, if the shrimp's not sitting on the hook just right, it'll tangle your line. That's why I like to hook it from the tail end so that it lays flat in the water. Oh, getting a little bite over here. Let me cast this one in. Thank you. Had our first little nibble of the day on the chicken liver chum bait. Oh, I'm getting two bites at the same time. There's one. Oh, he came off. He was just a little guy. Little cat hit on the shrimp. Well, at least we know they're biting, huh? Let's try this again. I'm just gonna use half a shrimp this time. That was a good bite. Let's see if he comes back for it. Seem to be biting on both. They're liking the shrimp a little bit more here than the chum bait. But I think we'll have better luck upstream. Let's go ahead and move upstream a little bit. See if we have any better luck over there. Oh, shit. Lost them. Oh well. Well. He just had a real good bite on that chum bait. Alright, so we moved up. Let's see. You can see that log jam over there. I'll leave the camera up like that. So, got a fresh piece of shrimp on this side. And some fresh chum bait on this one. Yeah, it's sad to say, I think the days are numbered on this fishing hole. Are you kidding me? He came off. Oh, and that was a good one. He hit on that chum bait though. Get it back out there. Wow, what a day. Nothing but misses, huh? That was a good sized cat, too. All right, so we moved up a little bit. And I found this little spot, so I'm gonna give it a shot. Take the chum bait out there. I think this one needs a fresh piece of shrimp. What are you doing, T-Bone? Hey, watch out, T-Bone. Getting in my line. Good boy. a fresh piece of chum bait. Oh, you're gonna bite over there. There's one. My weight's lodged. Let's go do a rescue mission, huh? There he is. There he is. First cat of the day. Not too bad. Little 2-pounder maybe. Yeah, he's about 2 pounds. You get on that shrimp. Healthy little cat. Whoop, there he goes. Get over here. We're going to go ahead and put him back. Get back in the boat and we'll throw that chum bait out. All right, we're upstream, fresh bait, nice little spot. Hopefully we'll catch something here. I'm parked behind a small island. The water comes around this side and behind me, and then they meet right here. So hopefully it'll be a good place to hold fish. Normally it is. I've caught many fish here, some good sized catfish. But with the water being so low, it changes everything. And I grew up reading the In Fisherman magazine, and then I was a big fan of the Catfish Insider magazine that was around for a little while. And one of the things that they said is that when you're fishing in a place like this, a stream, it's not really a waiting game. If the fish are there, they're going to bite. And you shouldn't wait any more than 15 minutes in a certain area for them to bite. If you wait 15, 20 minutes and you don't get any bites, then the fish aren't there. Or they're not active, and so you need to move to a place where they are active. And you know, it's really worked for me, that method has. Also, they say that there's one. They say that if you haven't gotten a bite, to move your line a little bit. It may be wedged somewhere where the fish can't get to it. Another little fish, not too bad. Another 2-pounder. But yeah, they say to keep your bait moving around so that you can put it in a place that it's easy for them to access. Sometimes it gets wedged between a log or underneath a rock or somewhere where they can't exactly get to it. So don't be afraid to move your bait a little bit. So that one hit on shrimp. This one hit before I could turn the camera on.
Alright, calm down.
There's another catfish, maybe about 2 pounds again. So they've been averaging 2 pounds today. All the ones that I caught were on shrimp. All the ones that I caught were on shrimp, and even though I did miss two really nice ones on the chicken liver chum bait that I did modify, I added the clam juice and the garlic powder to it. So that's all the time I have for you guys today, but I appreciate you guys watching, and as always, take care, and we'll see you guys next time.